गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर महजबीन फातिमा फ्रॉम सागर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ रिसर्च एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. दिस इंस्टीट्यूट कम्स अंडर द बैनर ऑफ सेज ग्रुप. आई एम टेकिंग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मेजरमेंट एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन. आई एम टेकिंग कैथोड रे ऑसिलोस्कोप, CRO. द आउटलाइन ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आर वॉट इज एन ऑसिलोस्कोप एंड विच प्रोफेशंस यूजिंग ऑसिलोस्कोप, देन ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द CRO कैथोड रे ऑसिलोस्कोप, हाउ दिस ऑसिलोस्कोप वर्क्स, वॉट आर इट्स बेसिक पार्ट्स एंड ऑपरेशन, एंड देन आई विल टेक द कैथोड रे ट्यूब. सो सी हियर, द स्टूडेंट्स जनरली मेक द ग्राफ लाइक स्टूडेंट्स टेकिंग द रीडिंग, सम टू रीडिंग्स एंड वन रीडिंग इज प्लॉटेड on the x-axis and other reading is noted down on the y-axis and a graph is plotted down. So such type of graph is possible to draw on the paper, but if we want to draw the signals, real-time signals which are present in the circuits, if the real-time signals propagating in the circuits, then what can we do? So the solution is the cathode ray oscilloscope. As oscilloscope, you can see here, this is the oscilloscope. This oscilloscope can be used to display the waveforms. You can see here the sine waves and the square waves are shown here. So in this, the sine wave and square wave and another waves are also possible to display. So basically the oscilloscope is a laboratory instrument and commonly used to display and analyze the waveform of the electronic signals. In fact, the device draws a graph of the instantaneous signal voltage as a function of the time. Most of the time, we do the display of the graph for the voltage with respect to time. So, oscilloscope is used to display and analyze the waveform, and this can be used to measure the amplitude of the signal and frequency of the signal and phase angle of the two signals if it is provided to the CRO. So the professionals which are using the oscilloscope, actually the physicists and the researchers, these are using the oscilloscope. The engineers and students are using it. The electronic technicians which are doing some changes in their project, in their circuits. So the electricians, electronic technicians can do the, can take use of the CRO, and health workers also, like if they want to display the signals like ECG signals. So the health workers are also using the CRO. So now you see here, this is the basic block diagram of the CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. See here, this is the electron gun which is generating the electron beam. This is the horizontal deflection plate, this is the vertical deflection plate. Horizontal deflection plates are placed vertically and vertical deflection plates are placed horizontally. So these are the deflection plates are used to deflect the beam. So basically this is what, this is the cathode ray tube and this is the heart of the oscilloscope. The CRO use the cathode ray tube, and inside of this the electron gun is present which is generating the beam, electron beam. Then horizontal deflection plate and the vertical deflection plates. When the electron beam passing through this deflection assembly, the electron beam get deflected in vertical direction as well as in the horizontal direction. The horizontal plates deflect the electron beam in horizontal direction, and vertical deflection plates deflect the beam in vertical deflection, vertical direction. And this deflected beam goes to strike on the screen. The screen is coated with the phosphor atom. So this is the screen. So this is the very basic diagram of the cathode ray tube, CRT. So now how an oscilloscope works. For this, here one diagram is taken. This diagram is called block diagram. In this you can see this is the Y amplifier, or you can say simple amplifier. This is a trigger circuit, time-based generator circuit, time per division, X position, volts per division, Y position, the input signal is given, This is the input signal which we want to display. This is a part of the CRT cathode ray tube. The cathode is present here, heater is present. Anode, vertical deflection plates, where the vertical deflection plates are also denoted by Y plates. X plates, the horizontal deflection plates, also denoted by X plates. Screen, which is coated by the phosphor atoms, which is coated by phosphor material. Now see, the Y amplifier is doing the amplification of the input signal. Trigger circuit trigger the time-based generator, and this time-based generator will generate the sawtooth waveform. This sawtooth waveform is going to the horizontal deflection plate. This input signal is going to the vertical deflection plates. Here cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the supply, and anodes are connected to the positive terminal of the supply. So when heater heat ups the cathode start emitting the electron, ray of the electron. This ray of electron is taken as electron beam. This is moving towards the anode and going towards the screen. This volts per division and Y position, time per division, X position, these are the front panel knobs. We will discuss about this later on. First, I want to discuss the function and the working of this block diagram. The input signal which we want to display, like this signal, if we want to display this signal, it is given to the probe, to the cable, and the cable provides this input to the amplifier. This amplifier amplifies the signal, and output of this amplifier is fed to the trigger circuit. Simultaneously, the output of this amplifier is going to the vertical deflection plate or Y plates. So the input signal is coming on the Y plates. As soon as this input signal arrives at the input of the trigger circuit, that output of the trigger circuit fade the time-based generator. So the time-based generator will start generating the sweep signals, and these signals going to the horizontal deflection plates or X plates. Now here, from here the electron beam is continuously emitting and is moving towards the screen. If there is no field, the electron beam will be moving in the straight and going to strike on the center of the screen of the CRO. But here the input signal is present on the Y plate and the sweep signal is present on the X plate. So these two signals creating their fields, and because of this, the electron when passes through this field, the electron will be deflected and going to strike on different places of the screen. So the electrons give their energy to the phosphor atoms which is coated on the screen. The phosphor atom, the valence electron of the phosphor atom, take the energy from the electrons and they come out from their valence band, but after some time they come back to their valence band, and when electrons of the phosphor come back to the valence band, they emit their excess of energy in the form of light. So in this manner the wave is displayed on the CRO. Now come to the block diagram of the cathode ray oscilloscope. Although this is also the diagram of the block diagram of the CRO, but here you can see here that all the blocks are same. Like here the horizontal amplifier is present, like here input signal is given. This is Y amplifier, or we can say vertical amplifier. This is a trigger circuit. Output of this going to the time-based generator, and output of this going to the amplifier. And output this time-based generator is generating the sweep signals. This is amplified with this amplifier and giving to the edge plate or the horizontal deflection plates. And the vertical amplifier output is going to the vertical deflection plate or the also called V plates and sometimes Y plates also. So but you can see the delay line is connected here. If the delay line is not connected here, as we have seen earlier, here the delay line is not connected. Now you can see here this input is going through the trigger and then time based generator, and then it is going to the horizontal deflection plates. Before this, one amplifier is also connected in the next diagram. So this sweep signal is going after some time, but before this the input signal is going to the amplifier. Just after amplification, this input signal will be available on the Y plates or the V plates. So this signal will be available before the horizontal deflection plate signals. So we want, if it happens, then electron start deflecting in vertical direction before the electrons start moving in the horizontal direction, and we want to synchronize the signal, the signal available on the Y plate and the signal available on the X plate. So we want to synchronize the signals of the vertical deflection plate and horizontal deflection plate. So for this reason, here the delay line is connected. So you can see here, one more time I'm explaining this, the input signal is going to the vertical deflection plate just after this amplifier, but the sweep signals are coming after the signal propagating from the trigger circuit, then the time-based generator generates the signal and then going to the amplifier, so and going to the horizontal deflection plate. So this will take some time to reach here, but before this the vertical deflection plates get the input signal, so the electron beam start deflecting in vertical direction before the deflection in the horizontal direction. So it is required to synchronize the vertical deflection plate and horizontal deflection plate signals. That's why a delay line is connected here, and this delay line gives the delay of 20 milliseconds to the input signal. After 20 milliseconds, this signal is available on the vertical deflection plate. So the horizontal deflection plate signal and the vertical deflection plate signal are synchronized by connection of this delay line, and then electron which are passing through this field, through horizontal and vertical deflection fields, so electron start moving in horizontal as well as in vertical direction and going to strike on the screen. So this is the use of the delay line here. In the CRO, delay line is used. You can see this is the high voltage supply. This high voltage supply is given to the CRT, to the cathode, and low voltage supply is given to the vertical amplifier, to trigger circuit, time based generator and horizontal amplifier. Low voltage supply is approximately 10 to 15 volts and given to the this amplifiers, and in the amplifiers and the time based generator here transistors are connected, so transistor can work on the 10 to 15 volts. So transistor, so the low voltage is given to the vertical amplifier, trigger circuit, time based generator and horizontal amplifier. Now this is the cathode ray tube. In this cathode ray tube, we have already seen the cathode ray tube, but I want to discuss it in brief. See here, the filament is connected here. This is the cathode. A cylindrical cathode is used here. This cylindrical cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the supply, and this one is the pre-accelerating anode, and then this is the focusing anode, this is the accelerating anode, this is the vertical deflection plates, that is Y plate, this is the horizontal deflection plate, that is the X plate, this is the phosphor screen. The screen is coated with the help of the phosphor, and all these assemblies, all these things are placed inside of a tube, and this tube is vacuum, the air is evacuated from this. So this much part, the cathode and the anode, accelerating anode and focusing anodes, this comes under the electron assembly, and a vertical deflection plate and horizontal deflection plate comes under the deflection system. So when this filament is heated up, the cathode start emitting the electrons, and the electron beam will be starting to move at the center of the CRT. But since the accelerating anode and the focusing anode are connected on the positive terminal of the supply, so the electrons are attracted and moving towards this, and as soon as this electron beam enters into the deflection system field, the electron experiences a force and start moving in vertical as well as in horizontal direction and going to strike on the different position of this screen. So the electron will give energy to the phosphor atom, and phosphor atom will display the waveform. In this manner the cathode ray tube works. So this completes my lecture. Thank you, student. See you next time. Bye.